welcome to EQ International Magazine, India's oldest and leading solar media. And today we have Mr. Vineet Mittal with us from Navitas Solar. A very warm welcome to EQ, sir.
Thank you. Hello. How are you?
Thanks, sir. Sir, can you just let us know about Navitas Solar, like from when it is in the solar industry and what are your plans for Indian solar market, basically?
So basically, Navitas Solar is a 9-year-old company. We started in 2013. We are a vertically integrated company having products from raw materials for the solar module itself as a manufacturing. Then we do project execution and some RESCO projects. Apart from that, we are also into complementary products like lithium-ion batteries, which is also under a new brand called Renon India. So we are the kind of a few companies in the market who are having most of the products in a single company.
As you said that you are into the raw materials of modules, so what about the distribution? Like, is it it's in the Indian market itself, or you are planning to expand, or you are right now exporting in international market as well, the raw material for modules?
So currently we are making EVA, ethyl vinyl acetate films. It's a new company, about 2 years now, and we have started supplying last 6 months. As of now, we are supplying domestically to the Indian OEMs, the Indian solar module manufacturers, pan-India. We must be having more than 40 customers already working with us. So they are all buying our EVA for their solar module requirements. Going forward in future, definitely we will be looking at export markets in Middle East. There are a few module companies there, and maybe the US, where there is some manufacturing that is going to happen very soon.
Okay, that's great. And if we like talk about the Indian market, so can you just let us know about what are the challenges you can get and the opportunities you have? As you know, the government has set few targets for the solar industry. So what do you think, would it be achievable, and how to go about? What's your view on the same?
So there are a lot of challenges in the Indian solar market ecosystem, no doubts in that. Whether it is in terms of policy, in terms of geopolitical issues like trade barriers, pricing issues globally, the container freight issues. So there is a lot of hiccups currently in the solar market. But the overall demand in the segment is growing. The awareness for solar market is growing. People are putting solar for their small residential of homes, for their factories, for their buildings, and for large power plants. So the overall demand is increasing, and that is why the market itself is growing. And maybe that is the reason that we might be able to achieve the targets, maybe 1 year plus or minus. It's not very important. But the important thing is that the solar market is growing, and there are new entrants in this market. The existing ones are expanding, whether it is in execution, whether it is in terms of manufacturing. So in spite of the challenges, the good thing to know is that the overall market is expanding very fast.
For the raw materials, can you share the roadmap of pricing and the technology that is being used to prepare the raw material for the same?
So as far as the EVA is concerned, it is dependent on the EVA resins that is not produced in India as of now, unfortunately. So we have to import from Korea. It's a global product, a petrochemical product, which is governed by crude oil prices. So in last 1 year, the resin prices have increased by more than double, and that's the reason our EVA film prices have also increased. Subsequently, the solar module prices have increased because of this. So this trend is still going further ahead. Still there is some inflation in the raw material pricing, and more importantly, because it is import dependent, the container freight is also a big factor. And we know the global positions for the freight cost in international shipping industry. So overall, the pricing is increasing, but good thing again here is that a lot of local companies who are coming into India and doing the last mile of manufacturing, the EVA film manufacturing in India. So at least to that extent, we are getting benefited. And also because we have some anti-dumping against imports, the Indian manufacturing ecosystem is getting a boost.
A rough number, if you can just mention, like how much till now you have supplied in India itself, in the domestic market, Indian solar market.
So currently we have a 1 gigawatt of EVA manufacturing capability. Since it's a new plant, about 6 months and initial few trials that have happened, I suppose we must have supplied close to about 50 to 75 megawatts of EVA. And in the next year, when we will be running full-fledged, after all the corona issues are getting settled down and we are getting team support and engineering support, so next year we are targeting at least 75-80% of our capacity in 2023.
And as you know, there are various international manufacturers and brands who are setting up in India, like they are joining the Indian market. So how do you feel, like would it be challenging or would it be an opportunity for the Indian brands and Indian manufacturers itself?
I would call it as an opportunity. Definitely it's a challenge. There will be more competition, but all the global companies would like to have a local partner. This is how I see this thing. They will be looking to tie up with Indian companies who are into the market since a long time, and they understand the ecosystem within India, how to manage the employees here, how to manage the government policies, the trade issues locally. So I think if actually the MNCs come in India and set up manufacturing base, they would be looking at some form of a support from the Indian counterparts, whether it in terms of management of the operations or creating a network in the market. So we see this as an opportunity rather than a challenge.
Would you like to share about the projects that are being undertaken right now and for the 2022 as well?
So our focus in the module market and our solar module business has always been distributed solar. We focus on open access projects. So we are supplying in few projects in Tamil Nadu, close to 15-20 megawatts at a single location for captive power plants. So these are textile mills who work there. Similarly, in Gujarat, we have done those kind of projects. And apart from that, lot of other distributed markets like pump businesses, rooftop businesses, almost pan-India we have been supplying. So the ticket sizes will be low, say a megawatt, 2 megawatt, half a megawatt. But then there will be multiple projects in different locations.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot for being with us.
Thank you. Thank you, and good luck to EQ team. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.